One of the notable things is the absence of the advertiser in today's meeting. Why is it that advertisers, as both of you I can ask that actually, are spending less and less time in attending measurement meetings? Not just IRS, it could be BARC, it could be anything. It's their money finally.
I think you've actually pointed out on a very right thing, and I would urge all advertisers to take this up very seriously. And any client who I meet, I always tell them this. They've sort of outsourced this to the agencies or to the media owners to some extent. Having said that, we've had very active participation, at least at the board level, at the TechCom level, both in RSCI and in MRUC, of several large advertisers. But I think it can and should be much more. They will gain a lot more out of that. Remember, there's another part of this research which we didn't really cover today, which is the product linkage data.
Right.
Actually, that product linkage data is of most interest and use to the advertisers, much more than it is to agencies and to publications to that extent. I think that's where their level of involvement will come much higher. To be fair, the fact also is that for the last 3-4 years, we haven't had a credible print research. So it's not unfair to see. They will be waiting to see that, is the research report first of all going to come out? There was a lot of question mark, will you be able to take out the research report? And then they're going to wait for the product linkage data, and once that comes in, I'm hopeful that their engagement going forward will now start increasing. But absolutely right point that you made, the industry needs a lot more of client participation, because only then can a sense of discipline and a sense of meaningful research happen, because ultimately all research or any media, anything, has to sell the product. That's right. The whole reason why we are doing it. So right. That's where you need their involvement.
Satya, you brought out a point and you were careful to underline that it was your personal view, and you said it half as a joke, which is maybe creatives should start looking not at just full page ads, but a higher frequency of smaller unit ads. You know, one of the things that will help marketers make that decision is granularity of data. Suppose I knew how many people read Wednesday Hindustan Times or Thursday Matrabhumi or whatever. That will help, but I don't have that granularity of data in the new scheme of things. Do I have it?
No. In fact, sorry for interrupting. There is a lot more granularity in the new scheme of things than compared to before. That right. Whole analysis of, in fact, thank you for pointing it out.
So 30 days, 7 days, 3 days, right.
Actually allows you better scheduling. It's actually right. A scheduling.
And actually all the points that you made is now available, and even much more than that is available.
So, Satya, can you carry me through?
Available to the subscribers.
So one is the depth of the information, one is the width of the information. In terms of, if I take print media as an example, earlier we captured only yesterday readership and total readership, which you never reported. Now we want the users to be empowered with all information available, as we explained yesterday, and 3 days and 7 days and a month. There is time spent in reading. There is source of copy.
Source of?
Copy. Did right. You buy, did you subscribe, did you borrow, did you read a library, that one.
Right.
Portions read, if 100 is the number of pages in a newspaper, 20 is the number of pages, which portions do you read, what proportion did you read? That's another question. Frequency, of course, is there. So there's a lot more of information available for the print publishers as well as the planners to exploit the data. And importantly, all the data will be now cross-tabbable with any other variable which is being provided in the product profile data or the lifestyle, some sections we've added. But all that can be analyzed with the current database.
Shashi, a lot of your brands, I'm asking you to switch hats to a Lodestar UM hat, are users of the glazed newsprint supplements. Now, we don't have a measurement of supplement readership. Now, and when you were asked, do you plan to, you said no. I mean, it was a rejection of, do you plan to it? On the one hand, you said, give us suggestions. That question was almost a suggestion. So why do you think that's left out?
So you see, it's an issue of the cost trade-offs.
Right.
All this, finally, this is a sample survey of a scale of this size, requires the cost. Not everything can be said on camera, but I think with Ashish's mind working, we are already working on 2000 forward. How do we make it more robust? How do we make it sustainable? His job as a TechCom head is to ensure that he gets the right research going. Our job is to A, make it inclusive to the industry and ensure the money comes in.
Right.
So, I mean, if BARC, since you belong to the TV industry, BARC would not be what it was if the money broadcast is not put in the money.
Right.
So if outlays on the previous measurement system was X, BARC was probably 2X and the money was found. So I think somewhere, the first hurdle we were crossing is that we are putting a research out after 3 to 4 years for whatever reasons, correct? So first is to put the research out in the next 2 months, ensure there's acceptability, as wide as acceptability as possible in the print industry. And after that, then move on to the next side, which is depending on if people bring confidence in what we have put out and the granularity of what we have put out, then we'll make it more robust and we'll make it bigger.
Right.
So the media personality fit.
Pardon?
One more research has been contemplated. You know, it might be sometime soon after we get this going well. Is the media personality fit study, which is a many of the niche publications, channels, stations don't get represented. Any of the be it in BARC or be it in IR, which are what I call less than 0.3-0.5% penetration, right? Like a niche channel viewership or a Business Daily readership or any of those, right? One separate study has been planned, which is catering to this section. It also includes the larger penetrated media, like the larger newspapers, where supplements will become one of the media to be explored in that study.
Satya, staying with you. Now, these are nothing. I could ask Nielsen this question. I'm asking you. If I remember right, Nielsen for BARC says TV penetration is 64% or something. For you, they say 61%. It's the same Nielsen. I've got to check this. I'm not clear.
No, so let me clarify. Probably some more than Satya, I know the answer.
Pardon? Yeah.
So I know the answer. As far as TV estimation is gone, in BARC, Nielsen has not done the estimation.
Nielsen is not doing it.
No, so let me be clear. Nielsen does the groundwork, correct? Nielsen does the research, correct? If you know the BARC structure, is a layered structure. There is a third party involved, which is Magic 9 and the BARC team. The estimation procedure is X.
Right.
Correct? So there's a procedure which is used there, and that procedure is in Sun Logic. These are all estimations.
Right.
And here, MRUC and Nielsen have worked together. So there's a bit of a difference in what I'm saying. Hear my words.
Right.
However, the point you're making is valid. One of the things we couldn't pull off this time, and which we probably hopefully will with the entire ecosystem, we must move to a common metric for TV, print, radio. So there's one baseline.
The internet, for God's sake.
Yeah, yeah. So yeah. One common baseline for everything, which is the next thing. But first, our whole focus is to get the act on the show on the road. Hopefully, if you're successful with this, the way we are going, then maybe that's the next step to go.
Okay. Ashish, you flipped from your last public appearance to today. So you were wearing a digital hat and you're wearing a, shall we say, total media industry hat today. And there, digital gets measured almost minute by minute. This is getting measured now after many years, but once a year. You think that is a viable measurement solution for advertisers?
So just tell you that this is not that it's being reported after this thing, but the research is a continuous, ongoing daily research, even for print. Right, so there is, the field is happening at an ongoing basis. Of course, it's up to us. We might, so far we've been reporting it annually. Like Satya was saying, maybe we should now move to 6 monthly and then maybe to quarterly. Remember that in print, the pace of change is not that rapid. It's not, if you're a newspaper reader, it's not as if one day you're reading something and the next day your habit completely changes. There is a pattern to that. Digital is something else. Digital is immediate impetus, immediate, and the pace of change is much, much faster. In fact, in digital, the single biggest problem I feel is that there is no agreed metric. So if there were an equivalent agreed metric in digital, that would really be great. At the moment, you tell me in India, what is digital measured on?
So I disagree with you. Where is digital measured?
There is no measurement.
Sir, you tell me where is digital measurement?
So every publisher...
There is no third party measurement.
Every publisher in digital is giving their own measure. I think
absolutely.
The need for the industry in digital is to have an agreed industry currency. And finally, I believe that all these currencies must come to a common platform and talk to each other.
The industry's reaction to this. I also want to ask what you wish the reaction would be. One is what you think and then one is what you wish.
I don't wish any reaction. As Techcom had, our job was to get a good product out. I think we've done a reasonably good job. I think, as is the case with any research, everybody wants their to be number one or number two. Everybody wants to have a higher profile of readers. When you have a higher profile of readers, you can't be number one. Your numbers will be small, right? That's the irony of research. Many, many publishers will be very, very happy with the outcome. There will be one or two publishers who will be probably not so happy with the outcome.
Right.
And that's part of any research.
Shashi, we've seen it in TAM, we've seen it in BARC, where the measurement agency or body has asked users to be responsible with the use of data. And we have seen an abysmal failure in that front. As in not failure by the body, failure by the users to adhere. So what can you do to make people adhere
to? So the point is, since you gave the Bark example, it's a terrific example. So Bark put today, Bark put out data at 11, and two news channels, your competitors were claiming number one parallelly. Okay, Bark has guidelines, as long as, so Bark has set up a huge mechanism for disciplinary committee and all that. And in my mind, within the context of the industry, finally this is self-industry, it's for the industry body. It's working very well, we hope and pray. If we can get there at that level, we'll be delighted.
Thank you so much, Ashish. Thank you, Shashi. Thank you, Satya, and all the best to you.
And he's the man who's done all the hard work.
I hope, yes, he has done all the hard work. I hope this goes smoothly. I hope this goes without rancor. Let there be differences. I hope they're discussed and resolved. Thank you so much.
Thank you for your wishes.
Thank you.